almost very common to find young men hunting for scrap metals and aluminium around neighborhoods. The tendency usually is to feel some sort of pity for them because it appears like scavenging from dirt. In reality today, and from research, those guys are a part of a value chain in a line of business that is fast becoming a gold mine. The collapse of iron mining ores in the country have led steel manufacturers and rolling companies with the option of encouraging idle people to come waste dump sites, mechanic workshops and streets for the remains of vehicles, articles, industrial metal waste and more, as alternative which even comes cheaper. This waste to wealth story takes us to a major hub in Lagos where everything and anything waste is assembled, knocked down, reworked into other use or sold as scrap to mills that may require them. We are talking about Owode Oniri in Lagos, Southwest Nigeria, known as Community for All Types of Scrap Metals. Welcome to this week's edition of Community Report. I'm your host, Olu Phillips. Owode Oniri Market is situated on Mile 12 Ikorodu Road in Kosofe Local Government. Before the construction of the now expansive World Bank-sponsored newly built Ikorodu Road, the spillover of activity of the Owode market had a toll on motorists and commuters who had engagements in and around this axis. Today, it is a different story. You need to get beyond these walls to get a glimpse of arguably West Africa's biggest scrap metal hub located in Nigeria. The market derives its name partially from what the market stands for. Owode literally means money has arrived, while Oniri stands for iron, metal types. It is a place where scrap has been redefined. Of course, on the shoulders of the road, you can still find flashes of what to expect on the inside of the market. Cart pushers, in anticipation of earning a living, wait patiently to be engaged. On the inside, you are greeted with an array of metals of all sorts. You really needed to have business to close up if you show up here, because for a first timer, nothing adds up, especially on how the business is structured around here.
Well, I wasn't there when this market, you know, was initiated, and this started from our fathers. My general chairman here happens to be one of the foundations then. He was around. He could tell much about it, but being the national secretary, I have to answer the question to the best of my knowledge. We have an history of 42 years now. Yes. that has the history. Then this place was a swamp area. This place was generally a swamp area. So our fathers, they came here, they started pouring, you know, all this mud, they started filling everywhere. And we were not brought here, to my knowledge, by the government. Okay. Our fathers bought this place from one big, a big family, Elias family. They are called Elias family. They paid for this land. So, and we have been paying our rights to the government, talking about taxes and every other thing. We have been doing it for quite some time now. So far, so good. Like I told you, the history is 42 years. We've been complying with government regulations. And when anytime government says this is their law and regulations, we are always, you know, one of the best people that comply with them.
Yeah, talking about before they started 42 years ago, what did it start as? What did the market start as? Who that came here initially? What were their plans?
Then,
what were they doing? And
the business you see them doing here today, it has been, you know, it has been done in the past. That's an island. They call that place Sura, and the other one, Idumagbo. We have Sura Market and Idumagbo, and this is what they have been selling there, irons, the new and the old ones, which some people refer to as the scraps. That is what they are doing there, but that place, you know, is being congested, so I have to look for a better site. That was why they came down here to Ikorodu Road. You have the people that deal with the market, that's the iron, raw iron. Okay. So after buying it, it now lies to you that came to buy, what you want to use it for, the formation. You can take some to the, after, you know, negotiating with me as the buyer now, and you are the buyer, I'm the seller. You negotiate with me, I give you my goods. You have to take it down. If you need a burnout, you know, to construct something on it, you take it to them. Those are the second thing. And we have the welder. Maybe you are constructing a big, or fabricating something big. So you have to go to them, they will do it for you. So that's just all. The seller, who are the people selling irons, the burners that will, you know, transform the irons, you know, they give it a shape to whatever you want it to be. And we have the welders, you know, the work of welders fabricating. So that's just it.
The business of recycling assumes a monumental degree and locked up in every aspect of the market, which is distributed into 11 lanes. Local steel companies will always require metal scraps to manufacture their steel products. It is also estimated that if Ajakuta Steel Mill was functional, it would be requiring over 50,000 tons of scrap yearly for production. Indeed, there is another wealth opportunity that can be galvanized from the scrap metal industry cluster like the Owodo Orina community.
Our customers, actually, we will never tell you we have one particular customers. You know, when you come to this market now, I sell to you. If the market is okay and serve the purpose you wanted to use it for, definitely you bring more people. You might even end up giving them my cards, so they will look for me and come. So that is why we gain our customers here in this market. People come from Ibadan, Ijebu, you know, all this far, Onitsha. They come down here to get our goods. Because some do tell us that not that they don't have this market in Kano. Or, you know, this Lagos state, they have it in various states, you understand? But it's very expensive there. But once you can come down to Owodo, you know, you've got whatever.
In terms of physical mapping, an attempt is made to have an arrangement that allows for monitoring and effective management by the leadership of the market. There are 11 lanes of business concern, and on each of the lanes, there are over 100 shops with ancillary business concerns, which don't necessarily own a shop. Put together, there are just above 1,000 shops.